Hey guys, in this week's video, we're going to be ironing out the details on iron deficiency anemia. We're going to be looking at what is iron deficiency anemia. We're going to be looking at the signs and symptoms of it. We're going to be looking at how to treat iron deficiency anemia and loads more. So first of all, let's begin with anemia. What is anemia? What does it mean? So it's a medical term and it means a reduced number of red blood cells within your blood. And there's loads of different causes for it, one of which is not having enough iron, so an iron deficiency, which makes iron deficiency anemia. So we all need a certain amount of iron so that our bodies can make healthy red blood cells, which are then able to carry oxygen to our cells and our organs. Now, when those iron levels are low, it's gonna mean that we're not gonna be able to produce those healthy red blood cells or enough of them, which is then gonna mean that we're gonna feel tired and we're gonna have low energy levels. So if it's left untreated, iron deficiency anemia can actually affect muscle performance, it can affect your immune system, it can cause heart problems, and it can cause problems in pregnancy for the mother and the child. So please do remember these symptoms. So if you're feeling tired, if you've got pale skin, feeling short of breath, if you feel like your heart is beating a lot faster than usual, if you're having brittle nails or any hair loss, if you're having a headache, if you're having a sore tongue, any of these kinds of symptoms should be prompting you to speak to your healthcare professional. So what actually causes it? Well, most often it's due to heavy periods or pregnancy. The World Health Organization, for example, believe that 1 in 3 women of reproductive age and 40% of pregnant women are anemic. Now, for someone who is not pregnant or who does not have periods, iron deficiency anemia can be caused by blood loss. Now, there's loads of different conditions that can cause blood loss. For example, if you have piles, otherwise known as hemorrhoids, if you have an ulcer within your stomach or your intestine, if you have inflammation of your bowels, if you take a medicine that causes you to have a stomach bleed, such as ibuprofen or aspirin. So there's loads of different reasons that can be causing the iron deficiency anemia. And this is why it's super important that if you believe you have any of the symptoms of anemia, that you speak to your healthcare professional. You speak to them so they can investigate, they can examine you, they can do blood tests, they can do whatever they need to do to find out what is causing it. That is the most important thing. So now let's say that you've been to your healthcare professional, they've done their investigations, everything's fine, but you've just got iron deficiency anemia. Now, let's look at my top tips on how you can treat it. Okay, so tip number one, you need to make sure that you're getting enough iron from your diet. So there's two types of iron that we can get from our diet. The first one comes from things like red meat, poultry, fish. The second one comes from things like vegetables, pulses, fruit. So it's super important that you try and keep a varied, balanced diet that contains both of these two types of iron sources. Now, let's say for example you're a vegetarian, then you can eat foods that are higher in iron. So for example, kale, it's got loads of iron in it. Spinach, apricots, cereals, nuts. There's loads of different foods, which I will leave a full list in the description below. Also, look out for iron fortified foods, sometimes bread, sometimes cereals. These have iron fortified in them, which means that extra iron is added in them. So this is gonna be really helpful as well. Moving on to tip number two, watch what you drink. Vitamin C has been shown to increase iron absorption, and as a result, drinking a glass of orange juice, for example, with your iron tablet can help. However, please do remember that caffeinated drinks like coffee, like tea, like energy drinks, they are not iron's cup of tea, okay? And the reason for this is that the caffeine actually reduces the absorption of the iron. So, whether you're taking an iron tablet or whether you're eating foods that are high in iron, you need to leave a gap between these caffeinated drinks and that iron source. I would advise you leave at least an hour or two between them. This is really gonna help with the absorption of that iron. And the same theory applies for calcium. Look, if you're having dairy products like milk, like cheese, if you're having a calcium supplement, for example, again, you need to separate the time that you have it from either those iron-rich meals or your iron tablets, because if you take them at the same time, again, it's gonna reduce the absorption of that precious iron that we've been trying to increase. So leave at least an hour or two between them. This is super important. I am going to leave more information about this in the description below, and I did go into a lot more detail about this in my iron video, which again I'm going to leave a link in the description below for you guys. Now, it's super important to remember that even if you have a great diet full of iron, this is not enough to treat iron deficiency anemia alone. This is especially the case if iron deficiency anemia occurs throughout pregnancy. So moving on to tip number three, I know this may sound obvious, but please make sure that if you are prescribed or recommended iron tablets or iron medication, that you take them properly. You take them as advised or as prescribed, because this is going to make a big difference on how much iron is actually absorbed and the treatment of your iron deficiency anemia. Now, it's important to remember that iron tablets do sometimes come with side effects. This is an unfortunate thing with the iron tablet. They can cause things like constipation, nausea, diarrhea. So it's super important that you speak to your healthcare professional about it and get any suggestions from them on what to do, because there's various things that they can advise you on. And in addition to this, I have made a video all about iron tablets, on how to take them, on how to build up your dose slowly if you are having side effects. So if you are interested, I've got loads more information on this in the description below. I've got to leave a link there for you. I'm also going to leave a link up here for you, so make sure you check it out if this is something that applies to you. So please remember, if you do have any of the symptoms of iron deficiency anemia we spoke about earlier, so feeling tired, pale skin, feeling short of breath, feeling that you've got a faster heartbeat, brittle nails, hair loss, headaches, sore tongue, any of these, then please do speak to your healthcare professional so they can investigate, they can examine, they can do the blood tests that are required and find out what is going on. So any symptom of iron deficiency anemia, you should speak to your healthcare professional about them, especially if you're over 60, you're pregnant, or you're experiencing any bleeding. I'm gonna leave a full list in the description below as well. Please read it. It's super important that you are aware of these symptoms and also these red flags on when you should speak to your healthcare professional. Your health is the most important thing, so please do read it. So that's the end of this week's video. I really hope you found this information useful. You are now an iron deficiency anemia pro. You now know all about why it happens. You now know all about the symptoms. You now know all about the treatments. You also know when to seek medical advice and all about the red flags as well. So you're a bit of an iron deficiency anemia pro. So tell your friends, tell your family, tell your loved ones, tell everyone, because you now know everything there is to know. Thank you for watching this week's video. I really hope you found this information helpful. And as always, sending everyone awesome vibes, and I will see you next week. I'm really enjoying these little information, handwritten text things that I'm doing. But please do let me know, guys, what you think of them. I know my handwriting is terrible, by the way, but I'm trying my best to write it as neatly as possible. I don't know how readable these are going to be from this angle as well, but you know, any feedback, guys, about these style. I used to do them in my older videos when I first started. I always used to write on cardboard and paper and stuff. I always used to find it quite interesting and fun to do. I feel like it helps break up the information, but please do let me know what your thoughts are on them, if you like them, if it gives it more personality, or you just rather us to write them, you know, on the screen, just like via the edit. So please let me know, sending awesome vibes. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.